Welkom to my channel. Welkom op mijn kanaal. Bienvenue sur ma chaîne. Welcome off my kanaal. Can you imagine just trying to make a video in 4 languages? I don't think that would work. So I'm using subtitles. So if you want to know how I use my subtitles, go check out this video.
I'm Kat and I'm gonna show you how I put subtitles on my videos. First of all, you have to go to YouTube Studio. You go to content and you go to the video that you wanna put subtitles on. Click on it. Then in the left hand column, you can find subtitles. The good part is that YouTube already does part of the work for you. Normally, they will create automatic subtitles for your video, which you can find right here. So, English, automatic captions, and then you see it's published, and you can go and duplicate and modify them right here. First thing that I check when I come here is the timing. So, you have to put in timing. So, here you can see from where to where they put on the subtitles that you put there. So what I will be doing now is checking if the timing is correct and if what's written in English is correct as well. As you can see, my name is always spelled wrong. It has to be Kat. Where I especially pay attention to is like names of cities, places, which are often spelled wrong, as you can see here.
If you're using city names like Brussels, Paris, London, yeah, I'm quite sure that YouTube will recognize it and put it perfectly. But like, if I'm telling you I'm in Hasselt today.
Hasselt is written like this. Like here, for example, it's not mall year, but it's mall year. Where I also look for in my subtitles is, you know, when you speak, you don't always say the sentences completely. So I look into the text that what I see on the screen is kind of an okay text to read.
Also, I'm taking out, like, you know, the, I don't know, well, maybe, yeah.
So I'm trying to make a sentence look okay. Because if we're gonna make the translations, the subtitle translations, automatically, if your text in English is kind of gibberish, it's not really a correct English sentence, it's very difficult for the automatic translation to make it into a good Dutch subtitle or German subtitle or French subtitle. So, and since my audience is also Dutch and German and French, I like them to have a pretty good subtitle, all right? That's important. If you put in some footage with some music and all that, it's often you will find that your subtitles, the timing isn't good. So that's what I try to check as well. So, as you can see here, I have music, but it's already starting to show what I'm gonna say after the music. So, what will I be doing? I'm gonna see where my subtitles actually have to set to start, and then I'll just change the timings here. So this would be right. So I'll put here 54, and then you'll see that it gets corrected. You see down here, it's also, you have your timings down here as well, which means you can also use your mouse to change it a little bit, like here. Often when you put on music, it will say music or applause or maybe thank you, but it doesn't mean anything because you don't really say anything. So what I'll do, I usually take those out. When I have gone through all the English subtitles and I'm quite happy what I'm reading there, then my next step is, of course, saving this. I will publish. And when it's published, I can go for the translations, making the other subtitles, which is not too difficult. I'll show you. Now I have the English subtitles published. I can add a language. I will always put the Dutch subtitles first because that's my mother tongue. So when I have translation, I can check them if it's a bit correct or not, and maybe even change the English text a little bit before translating it to German and French. But how do you do the automatic translation? I will quickly show you. I have Dutch here now, so I'll add the subtitles right here. And here it says automatic translation. And then you'll see that out here, it's all nicely translated into Dutch. Great, isn't it? Mm-hmm. And so I go through them, I read them, I will do some updates. You can also see that the names that I changed, the towns like Hasselt, you can see they're all here nicely translated and correctly spelled in Dutch. So when I'm through this, when I have checked it all, I will publish right here. After I've put in and checked the Dutch subtitles, I might go back into the English one, because if I found a weird translation, that something, a sentence that didn't sound right, I'll go back into the English one, put it a little bit different, so that way when I translate it automatically into German and French, it should be okay. But let's now put on the German and the French one. Easy. Something else you can do right on this page is adding a title and a description in another language, if you like to do that. So if you want, then you have to add it here, like in Dutch, I could do that. I can just simply copy what's in here. I can make a translation, whatever. It's not an automatic option here to translate whatever is here, right there, but it does work pretty good. I hope this video was helpful if you want to make your own subtitles on your videos. And it's a bit of work, but I think it's worth it because that way I know my Dutch audience is happy as well. And I have some French and German, so yeah, I like to do that for them. And in fact, since YouTube does it automatically, it's not that really that hard work. All right, but thank you guys for watching. I hope it was interesting and I'll see you out next time on another adventure. Right. Bye.